Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I like to thank all my subscribers all over the world for subscribing me and making my YouTube channel Marine Tech Hub to the highest level. So I would like to tell a little bit more about my channel. I have been running this channel for the last 5 years. Last 4 years the channel was free. Now I have come to a level where I got the membership. So membership level 1, 2, 3, the level membership 5, which is ₹3999. In this channel where I will be giving you all the videos for 1 year, plus I will be helping you for all the troubleshooting at real time from anywhere. So lot of superintendents, chief engineers and all engineers are calling me for troubleshooting. I am very happy. It was my dream that I should have a channel like this where I will be able to help people and shipping companies to save time and money. So you can always choose whichever membership you want, but level 5 I will give you all the help, and online training I'm giving you online training for ₹1499. Plus, if you want to subscribe, you can pay me. The bank details are here. If you want to pay through bank, and you can, if you want to pay through Paytm, you can scan the QR code. So I'll very much thankful to all the subscribers again, and have a nice day. Thank you. Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I'll explain about dry dock job with respect to propeller. So this is a very important job. This will be carried out when the ship is in the dry dock. Before the job is carried out, in the morning we have conduct the toolbox meeting and the risk assessment involved in the job. All the officers in charge for doing the job from the shore and the ship will have a discussion of the various thing which will be done. So let's begin explaining little bit about that. So machinery data with respect to the propeller, we have number of blades 4 and the diameter is 6.6, that is in meters, and if it is 6600 mm. So the weight of the propeller is around 20,070 kg here, and the material of the propeller is nickel aluminum bronze. Okay, the jobs to be done, you can say they are telling that the risk assessment should be carried out, health and safety precautions to be taken. Then what they are saying is with respect to lifting equipments, and that will be supplied by the shore guys. So use of hazardous material. Then they are talking about staging should be done for the work, and they are talking about the ballasting of the ship's hull. When it is done, it should be done such a way that it is not hampering the propeller job. Okay, the test, what they are saying is the visual check by the ship staff. Okay, that is will be done. And we'll be using the proker gauge to check before the propeller is removed. I'll be explaining about the proker gauge. Then the die penetrant test will be done. MPI test, that is magnetic particle indicator test. Okay, this is MPI test, magnetic particle indicator test, and it will be witnessed by the surveyor. Okay, now you can see the ship is in the dry dock. You can see the sea water here, and you can see the gate. The ship has come inside and the water has been removed, and now the ship is in the dry dock. Okay, so this is now the job will be done. So one of the reasons for the repair, what we are doing is visual examination, NDT, non-destructive test, class survey, polishing, item. Okay, the scope of the job, they're saying. So they're telling what will be the scope of the job which will be done in the dry dock. Okay, the removal of the propeller is there, cleaning, polishing, NDT is nothing but non-destructive test. Then the class survey will examine it. So they are telling rope guards. So if the propeller has to be examined, so you have to remove the rope guard and see any and check the condition of the anodes. The rope guard has got an anode there, which I will show in the following part 2 of the video. So work description is given here, what will be done. They are saying propeller jobs and the hull treatment must be planned and carried out in the same period when the vessel is in the dry dock, ensuring that there is no interference between both the work. Okay, so hull treatment will be there, propeller job, so they should not hamper each other. That is very important. And they are saying, okay, you have to erect towers in such a way that you will be able to work on the propeller hub, and hub will be removed, and you should be able to turn the propeller when the staging is there. At least 10 person will be working on that. Very important. The second thing is, when the main engine is in the unit number 1, you have to turn the engine in unit number 1, that is TDC, and check and record propeller top position and put a marking on the propeller hub. So this has to be done by the chief engineer. Okay, so if you see now, this is Dubai dry dock, where you can see there are two ships in the same dock. So this is the ship where we are working, and this is the other ship. So very important. So in part 2 of the video, I will be explaining you how the propeller will be removed, what are the jacking procedures, and this is very important. So for persons who are going for dry dock, this will be very important videos for you all to know what is happening. And if you like the video, please subscribe, and the email address is there, telephone number is there. Okay, have a nice day. From Marine Tech Hub, we always try to help all the people around the world. And if you like the video, please subscribe, and you can have a membership. I'll be helping you out. Thank you very much.